Guys, I moved. I just moved into my new apartment in Vienna, which I'm going to use to study at university. I know it sounds very boring, but this is something that I wanted to do for such a long time. And I'm happy that it's finally time to do it. And I'm still going to do content for you guys, so there's nothing going to change. But of course, the background's going to be different because I'm at a new place. It's going to be a lot of fun. Mic's a little bit further away. I changed some things about the stream also. Make sure to check out the Twitch link is down below. Already streamed today. Now it's time for the first YouTube video, which is going to be Henry's offense. Henry just won the biggest tournament of the year thus far. And he was killing it on offense. Like, one of the best players on defense pretty much in history in Noah Johnson. He had no clue what to do. Like, he played good defense, don't get me wrong. But in the important moments, we just saw the prolific offense from Henry. And this is what I'm going to show you in this video. Henry runs the Washington offensive playbook. It's a great playbook. Has got bunch. Has got tight. Also has normal Y off week, which is something that I've been dabbling in a little bit. Maybe I'll do an ebook on that in the future. But for now, I'm not planning on it. Good offense though. So you definitely want to check that out. K-Mac runs it. Or he used to run it last year. I don't know if he's running it currently this year. Very good playbook. He likes to have two outside apprentices on his wide receivers. One on the right, one on the left, to just make sure that he always can run his C routes. That is one thing that you will notice very consistently. He likes to run his C routes to get a lot of yards against man, and also has some very nice zone concepts that'll beat zone with the C routes that you're not going to be expecting. The audibles you want to be going for are mesh post, halfback base, verticals, and bunch trail. I'm going back and forth between halfback base and Connor Y. I like base more, but if you like Connor Y more, do you, man. That's your offense. Now we're going to call the play FLN. And the only reason why I like to run that play is because it can sometimes beat cover three. So if I flat Jefferson right here and then backside, I want to put Devontae Adams on a C route just like that. Then you see, oops, my bad. he just got sacked. But if I go into instant replay, then I can show you guys that we can get a step. This is not the best cover three beat in the game, but that is the only reason why I like to run this play. And it's a play that is specific to this playbook. So I just wanted to make sure that it's right there. You see he drove on it, but you see he's still shuffling and we'll get a step on him. I'll try it one last time, but this is not something that I run too often. I just wanted to make sure I put it in there because somebody's going to be like, hey, you didn't put this play in there even though it beats cover three. You see it does. It's a pretty close cover three beater though, so it's not my favorite. Let's now talk about one of my favorite plays, which is verticals. I'm only going to break down three plays in this ebook. Now that sounds crazy. And Madden is a lot about freestyling, but those are the plays that are specific to Henry that he liked to run. And you can do a lot of stuff out of it. So we're going to call verticals for now. And the first setup for this is just a natural cover four match bomb. Just very simple. Of course, I didn't turn on match right there on defense. You have to make sure that your opponent is actually turning on his match, because otherwise this match bomb won't work. And here's zone coverage. Should be on match, my bad. Okay, it's the glitch again, but right there you see it's on match. Cover four quarters. Verticals. And all you're going to do for this is you're going to streak Jefferson. And you can keep Jones on this check and release, but I like to block him or put him on an in route just like so. And now you see how we will get a... Oh my... Why was that just played right there? That was very rude. Let's try that again. This is something that I just ran earlier today on stream. I don't know why this is not a thing. This should not be being played. Let's try it again. Am I missing something? Maybe if I... This is confusing to me. Let me try this again. Dude, this is playing it. I've never seen that happen. Wow. Amazing. This is like the one cover four match beater that I had. That's awesome. I don't know why. Excuse me. I'll spy these guys to just make sure I get all the time in the world. But I don't know why this is not beating it, you guys. Snap. Yeah, snap, pass lead it all the way inside. I mean, I guess he's got a step, but this is supposed to be way more open. Weird, huh? Is that not just the most amazing thing in the world? In Ultimate Team, this worked just fine. I don't know, practice mode might be weird. Okay, this works, but I gotta put a disclaimer on it that it might not work all the time. I don't know why this is not, this is the most confusing thing in the world. Like, this is a, this has been a cover four beater for years at this point. Like, this is one of the most consistent cover four beaters or cover four match beaters now in this game. Sometimes if people get bumped, then it might be crazy, but oh, tough. Absolutely wild. Wild stuff, you guys. Wild stuff. Casting it all the way inside. Yeah, he made a play on it. He tip drilled it to himself. Okay. You live and you learn. This is apparently no longer a good thing. But a very good thing is just to play like this. I just like to run like that a lot of the time. And then you can look to undercut that. Of course, that was a very bad throw. But just make it read against cover four match. I might have some troubles going up against in the future. Because, yeah, if this is not working, then... ooh, this might be a very, very tough defense. But yeah, just against any coverage, just running back is a very, very consistent thing. You can just thump it down to him. Verticals, you guys know verticals. The generic setups, you know them all. Excuse me. I like to run something like this. I would like the setup to actually be shown. I like to run something like this. This is a very simple cover four quarter setup. It's right there. You can just check it down once again against match. I got some match videos that are coming up in the future videos. I'm gonna make an ebook on the West Coast gun bunch. I'm gonna do every single bunch in the game, guys. Trust me. But no, for West Coast, my new offense, absolutely loving it. That offense has a lot of match videos. I don't know why this is not working so hot right now for the moment, but fine. Let's get into the Henry specific stuff. So the way that Henry likes to, as I can't, hot rod again. The way Henry likes to attack defenses is with C routes. Now this C route right here on the left, Adams, it's going to beat man coverage. So cover four match, if you guys don't know, the single receiver in the bunch is played man to man, where the cornerback right here plays man to man about against that wide receiver. So now you see that this converts to man and we get a step on. Like, this C route is a very, very consistent man beater. Also, funnily enough, early on stream, I had this bagged by man a couple of times. Really weird stuff happening in this game, but you see, practice mode, it still works, and it should also work in the game. I got it to work a couple of times in the game as well, so guys don't worry about it. But yeah, this C-Rop beats man, and now we need to supplement it to also make it beat zone, because if we only can only beat man and I cannot beat zone, then that's bad. So the way that I like to run this, or like, my bad, the way that Henry likes to run it, or the way that I have found it to run most effectively, is to have the wheel route to Jones, which you can quick throw, of course, streak Cobb, put Lewis on a drag, and then motion snap him across the formation just like so. And now you see that we can look to hit that corner route against cover two. Against cover three, we can also look to hit that. Let me just quickly audible to cover three. So there you go. You have your setup. Going to snap the ball, and the way that you want to pass this is with the free form all the way to the left. Now, of course, the cover four match actually just played it, which is annoying. Can I change to turn off the match by just protecting the sticks, which that should work. Of course, cover three match is something totally different, but pretty much nobody. Okay, now this turned it off. Okay, then you can just throw that with a pass lead all the way to the sideline, free form it. If you pass that regularly, then it's a pick. This is a very tight window, but this is something that Henry was going back to pretty consistently. So now let's go to a red zone play. Let's move the ball down here. And this is the way that Henry likes to attack in the red zone. He had his verticals just like this, and he just streaked the running back. That was it. Right there, hit it to him and try to get some yards up the field, because it's so difficult to pass from within the red zone. And he just threw high balls. That's it. Right there, if you see that, high ball it to Mercedes Lewis and hope to come down with it. And there you go. That's a touchdown. But there's not much more that you can do. You can then also look to hit R1 on a high pass. Of course, that's going to be covered by match. But for example, if your opponent plays cover two, which I will audible into right now, cover two, you see how we can hit that. And Randall Cobb is not even that tall. But if you've got someone like Randy Moss there, that's a pretty good target. Of course, I recommend Donald Parham at the tight end spot for this specific play. It's right there. You see me almost getting the ag, but we got hit just in time. And that is a very consistent thing. Ag catches are still happening in this game. It's right there. Can I pass leave that inside? I actually can. But that's not a consistent thing, guys. Don't throw that ever. Honestly, don't throw that ever. But that is basically my red zone offense for the moment. Of course, in the red zone, also, you should run the ball if you can. That is pretty much it for these setups that Henry likes to do specifically. Of course, I can always highly recommend a setup like this, where you have drag in and then crosser. So boom, 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 snap the ball right there, look to hit the tight end. The tight end on a drag is a very consistent thing that you can throw against cover four match. Just want to point that out. But there are many plays, there are many steps out of verticals, pretty much infinite possibilities, just because you have so many good routes that you can throw. But we're going to keep it moving, and we're going to talk about mesh post now. And mesh post is great at beating man coverage. You will see that I have short in lead on Justin Jefferson, and he just absolutely fries. That is a consistent thing. Seen that in Mutt a couple of times. This is my number one man beater right now, just because a lot of people are not used to facing this, and they're just used to facing corner routes. But this just absolutely smokes man coverage. You love to see it. Now, it's all about freestyling in this year, and the way that I'm currently freestyling is I only have one outside apprentice, but if you have two outside apprentices, that's fine too. You can go for a setup like this. I like to re-wheel my running back, streak Randall Cobb, motion Mercedes Lewis across, put him on a drag, and then you can make a couple of reads. Of course, the Z-Rod is going to be there. We just bumped into each other, but the C-Rod is going to be there against man coverage. The post is going to be there against man coverage. A motion snap drag also does a good job of beating man coverage. I just motioned the wrong guy. It's fine. You can even flip it like this and it will also work. It's right there. You see me? Even though we get bumped, Justin Jefferson gets the step. And we can throw it against man coverage pretty consistently. Of course, if we face cover two, similar things do apply. Snap the ball. All right, I can hit the C route, but if I just want to check it down pretty simply, I can just make the read between the post and the tight end. Of course, the tight end is going to be open most of the time. You should be taking that as much as you can, because if you get too greedy and only look down the field, that's where you can start to make mistakes. But once again, man coverage, we just turn him around. There's no way in hell that man coverage is going to defend that consistently. If you just call this play, let's say four times a game, I don't guarantee, but you're going to have a lot of success with this play. Obviously, you're not going to get a touchdown all the time, because sometimes you're just going to get chased down. But one of the routes is going to get open against man coverage. One of the best concepts in the game. Just want to once again reiterate short in lead and this post. They work wonder. Absolutely love it. Now, the last play that I want to talk about is bunch trail. Bunch trail is amazing. For very similar reasons. We can, once again, backside to the same concept that we've done for a lot of the plays in this video. And then, on the bunch side, we can do something like this. Just streak Jefferson, motion him to the outside. A good route that is not often talked about is this angle route. It's got a nice timing. It goes back across the middle. Basically, once the dust clears, the dust settles, the middle of the field is just wide open, because your user just scrambles away trying to cover a corner route or try to cover the running back on his wheel route. You can look to hit Mercedes Lewis. Now, of course, the reason why your opponent is going to cover the corner route manually is because this corner route is absolutely money. If you guys don't know, freeform settings on placement and accuracy, near and 20 out of 20, because then you'll never miss a throw, but you have the maximum flexibility with your reticle. Snap the ball once again. Nice. We're going to lead that away just like that. Of course, I led it a little bit too far there. But you guys see there's a window there. I would look to hit the other corner route if I were you against cover three. That's just me though, because the other corner route just feels a bit safer. Feels like it's a little bit easier to throw. Right there, dragging the feet. Absolutely love to see it. And yeah, that is pretty much the setup that I have for you guys. If you're going with two outside apprentices, you can even run something like this where you motion Jefferson to the outside. And the good thing is, while someone is in motion, you can make infinite hot routes. So I recommend the first thing that I would always do is wheel the running back, then motion Jefferson to the outside, put him on his route, and then do all the other hot routes at the same time, and then motion him back in. That's when you can do the protection. Basically, your quarterback does not go through the animation, and it just means that you can hot route a lot faster. In this case, oh my God, I just threw it behind him. Bad pass lead by me. But in this case, I would just check it down to the tight end. And once again, there you go. Now I can slide. I can ID the mic right here. I can motion back to the inside. Snap this ball. And yeah, just have a lot of success. Lead that all the way away from my right receiver, of course, right there. That's the thing with freeform passing. If you put it all the way to the edge, if there's a little bit of a mistiming, if the route is not ran 100% the way that it is supposed to, just because he gets bumped or has a little bit of a stutter in his route for some reason, then it's going to mess it up. But right there, you see great timing to a perfect ball right there, leading it to where only my receiver can get it. And yeah, that's it. I want to end off on a very, very nice note. Just run the ball. Very, very simple. That's where I get myself into most trouble. If I don't think, okay, run the ball, be smart. If you run the ball and you play this game the right way, you'll have a lot of success. The next thing I'll do is I'll make my defensive ebook, in which I will explain. My bad. That's petty. That was a bad though. I'm drifting off, throwing it, thinking about defense, and I'm going to throw it right to them to make sure I show you how good my defense is. But for real, let's go full screen. Let's talk about this. Next ebook is going to be my defense, just because defense is so important. If you don't make mistakes on offense, you will win a lot of games. That's honestly the only thing that happens to me when I lose games. My offense doesn't perform. Generally, my defense comes to play. My defense comes to fight. If my opponent is really good on offense, if I'm playing Greeny or someone, if I'm playing Pavan Lakat, shout out, check him out, great YouTube videos, then I'll struggle on defense. But generally, the regular person is not, he's not giving me too much trouble. I hope you guys learned some from watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please subscribe to the channel. Also, hit the like button. It supports the video. Make sure that YouTube pushes it to more people. But yeah, I'm out. New apartment. I'm going to do an apartment tour very soon. Hope you guys are tuned in for that. It's not a big apartment. I guess it pretty much is, but there's not too much stuff going on. I still have to do some of the decorating, some of the... got to move the table right here to just make sure we got some drinks to put down when we're partying. That's what the cool kids do, I guess. But yeah, a lot of exciting news. Still got to figure out the lighting. Of course, this is not ideal right here. I have my light source. I still have to set all this up, but just wanted to get this out to you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Hope you guys had fun. And yeah, see you in the next video. Peace out. Check out the Twitch.